This is where me and the Pink Ninja have slept. We have the oven there, one cot there. Hello guys, welcome back to the channel, welcome to Survive Russia. This video here is gonna be an in-depth review on the UP2 tent from the Russian manufacturer PF Berik. Berik means riverbank, blah 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 blah. This is most likely one of the most versatile tents you will be able to find. It can be used in very hot weather and it can be used in Arctic conditions actually. Super awesome tent. I'm about to pack it down. I've been here for 2 days with the Pink Ninja. We are in the little vehicle there. So enjoy the video and remember to check the links in the description to PF Berik, to the manufacturer there. And I would like to point one thing out. I am not paid by this company at all. I've been using this tent for about a year or something like that. But check it out, it's super, super awesome. We have the tent here in its full glory, in its full bag. And we have a car full of stuff here as well. The UP2, the standard version here, I think it weighs about 23 kilos. The straps here can of course be used and adjusted as a backpack. And I think I will put in some footage right now where I'm actually hauling this tent and the stove, the whole setup. Something like 80 kilos, 170 pounds or something like this on a sled, actually to this location here. So let me try and use this guy here as a backpack and haul it all the way up to the campsite. It must be at least 10 meters away. And like this, it can of course be carried for, I don't know, kilometer, 2 kilometers, 3 kilometers, how much you really need to carry it, but yeah, no problem. That was the toughest 10 meters I've ever done. It's a very sturdy bag, sturdy ziplock, fasteners everywhere, so it can be compressed to a minimal size, you can say. Wait, that's a little funky guy. Better get him off and safe out into the woods. But let's pitch the tent. And pitching the tent is super easy. This is one of the awesome things about the tent. That is that if it should be raining and so on, it's super fast just to get shelter. Then you can always tie out the guy lines and all this stuff. This is the door, that's the floor. We should have a rain fly somewhere. Yeah, we have the rain fly here. Here we have the tent. And as I said, it's super easy to pitch it really fast. Over the tent bag, we have the floor and we have the door. And over there, we have a new moon. But just for this evening here, it could be funny just to show the simplest setup, and that is simply just to pitch it like I did. The Pink Ninja, she wants to work with the guy lines and so on. But for a place like this, for weather like this, it's absolutely not needed. The floor is not even needed. The very first thing we need to secure is, of course, the strap, which holds the tent together, so to speak. I think we have some rain coming, actually. You can see it's a giant umbrella construction, basically, and everything is aluminium and steel. So yeah, I'll show you that a little bit later, because wind is really kicking up now. Sometimes it can be good to just, yeah, to flip up this joint a little bit. We have the entrance. So inside here we have a giant umbrella stick, basically. Now we actually already have shelter, right? That is pretty awesome. Down here in the little compartment here, we have a bag with some tent pegs. We have some more tent pegs here. We have a whole lot of cordage, because there's a lot of attachment points on the tent. We have some spare parts. And we have some repair materials, some small screws and a buckle and stuff like that. It has officially started to rain, so let's get it done. Let's get the floor in and the door in. All right, so down here we have the floor. Here we have a big, what you can say, a big opening for the oven. Here we have some openings which can be used for, I say openings, because we have one there and one over there, and these can be used for ice fishing and stuff like that. All right guys, so the firewood is ready, the oven is up, it is time to warm up a little bit, I think. Let's get this guy in here, because as I said, it is officially raining.
Oh my friends.
Right, since we have a quite hard winds kicking up, then I will attach three tent pegs right at the entrance here. That's because we're gonna use the door. It kind of supports the door. You will see what I mean in a second. Here we have the door. Of course the tent can be used without the door. There's three different layers in the entrance there. But the door is super awesome. So why not use it? Like this. Door attaches to this double Velcro thingy here. Here we have Velcro on both sides. So how I install the door is that I start from the top here. It's of course a little bit tricky with double Velcro, but it's worth it. Like this. Duck. Let me just bend this flap and it's in place. And to show it real fast, it locks in the bottom, and at the top we can open. Airplane grade aluminium assembly, no cheap stuff. And the tents are all hand sewn, I have to point out. As you can see, the tent has reflexes on it. But since the company, they make custom orders, I'm pretty sure that if you want one without it, they will make it. But I find it to be pretty awesome. Alright guys, we're on day two. Me and the Pink Ninja, we had an awesome sleep, of course. This is a really, really awesome tent. And yeah, after using it about a year, we have some wind going on there. After having used this tent here for about a year or something like that, I mean, I cannot find anything or haven't found anything that I dislike about it. It is generally an awesome tent. This is where me and the Pink Ninja have slept. We have the oven there, one cot there, one cot there. That's where I've been sleeping. Pink Ninja over there. When using this tent with two bunks then and the oven, then you of course have to set it up like I've set it up right now. That means that we use this entrance there, and that entrance there will not be used, but it can still be used for unloading and unloading equipment and blah blah blah, like we did yesterday. There we have the oven. The oven is super awesome. The windows here, they radiate more heat out than just ordinary stainless steel. There are some special panels that you can replace these windows here with if need be. It is not very warm today. It's +9°C and the night was about +3°C, and it's actually quite nice to be able to have a dry zone here where we can run the oven. And of course we're running the oven with the open door and with open vents. I even open the vents during winter as well. But about the cots, it's definitely best to use cots when you are sleeping in this tent here, because it's the kind of the ideal height for where the heat is, so to speak. The cots, they provide storage space, which is quite important. There's storage space over there as well. We have good amount of storage space down here. But the awesome thing about this tent, or another awesome thing about this tent here, is that it can be completely disassembled. Inner tent, outer tent, and even the frame can be repaired and all sorts of stuff. I just changed the camera here to give you a better view of the frame and stuff. But you can see, hopefully,
Here we have a sleeve with the Velcro on. We have some small Velcro tabs here. We have a airplane grade, I think it's 6061 aluminium. All the uprights here are from aluminium. Here by the window, you can see another example of the sleeve, aluminium. The links there, they are also from aluminium, airplane grade. And up there we have the main assembly. All metal construction, super awesome. The fact that the top part of the inner tent is white is super, super awesome because it makes light in here, right? Also, we have this funky organizer here, can be removed. It's sturdy, it's not flimsy at all.
The outer membrane is, as far as I remember, called the Oxford PU300. I am not sure about 100% sure, but there will of course be links in the description to this tent here. I know quite a few guys from the US, from Canada, Sweden, Germany, Britain, I think as well, have bought this tent on my recommendation, of course, and I have not had one single negative comment about it. Everybody thinks it's awesome, and this because it is really awesome. As I said, you can even use it in super Arctic conditions. There's a heavy-duty Arctic cover, orange Arctic cover for the tent here. The tent here have so many useful features and is so well thought out that I say it's impossible to cover it all in a reasonable amount of time unless I have to make a video on 1 hour 15 minutes or something, and I don't want that and you don't want that, but I can highly, highly recommend it. So about all the details which is to be found on this tent here, I mean, we can open this guy here, then we can separate these two layers here. And then you'll have more light in the tent, it will still be waterproof. And as far as I remember, yeah, this can be, no, this cannot be totally removed, but we have the toggles here to roll it up and keep it in position. So there's the tent, all packed up. So guys, I hope you liked the tent, I hope you liked the review, I hope you will check the links in the description, and I hope you will consider supporting the channel, the vehicle project and all that good stuff. And until next time guys, get out and train, get it done, do something awesome, and see you in the next video.